I cannot do it. I might be a big imposing guy, but I'm a gentle soul. I don't like shouting. I don't want to be in the place. I just want to make this music from a place of peace and love. It's important to me. Alright? So let's have that. My friend Rick, who I started this band with in 1977, I think. I'd like to have him say a few words. Rick Steiger.
It is great to look out and see everybody. I think what I want to talk about is Jefferson Chalmers.
Yeah.
That's where this band came together. RJ was living on Ashland. You see Maurice and Bruce are all here. It was a great scene going on in Jefferson Chalmers in the 70s. There was a lot of good vibes, a lot of good spirit. And it was the Catacombs Coffee House in the basement of St. Martin's. And that's one of the places that this band worked. First time we called the band Kula. But there was a whole lot of things that came together in that neighborhood. And if you read the program, you can see how it all came together. But RJ and I had spent, we met in 74, right around this time, in 1974. And we became fast friends, and we went and saw a lot of concerts and did a lot of stuff together. And then it became our turn to turn out some of this music. We become thoroughly obsessed with as you know, Sun Ra, big Sun Ra people. Yeah. We got way into South African music.
Yeah.
And that connection for me goes right back to RJ, to his uncle. We used to listen to WDET, right? Back in the day, we got WDET people here.
Yeah.
A lot of us, on Monday nights, you know, there used to be the Jazz Today Show, and RJ's Uncle Bud's band went on that show. That's right. And I heard he played a record by Dollar Brand, Abdullah Ibrahim, and that sent me in a whole other direction. And so we found a lot of South African stuff, and there was the emerging world music scene that was happening at that time. It was a lot of the, you know, world music kind of got sort of co-opted and didn't really take off in this country like some of us had hoped. But, and of course it kind of got co-opted into a reggae thing, but back in the 70s, it was the jazz people that were talking about, you know, world music, African rhythms. And so in our neighborhood, we had the Hollis brother, we had Akunda here. He's a master of drums and master of African rhythms. And then, of course, in our neighborhood, was Mr. James O'Donnell. Hey! That's right, Lakewood player. That's right. And a couple down from him, from the neighborhood, was Mr. James Kane. And he's been here for a little while, but if you've ever heard of James, James is a man of many nicknames, right? James O'Donnell, you know? But have you ever heard of him called James Guts O'Donnell? The nickname comes because it was James Blood Kane, and so I said, well, blood and guts, right? Both guys named James. So that's where that came from, all right? So,
40 years later, still
jazz, on bass, Mike went to school with RJ. And, I don't know, Sule wasn't on the east side of our, we met him through Roy Brooks, or I'm not even sure. RJ knows all those roots. But, and then Fred came in, and Tim, a couple of west side guys. And, but then also, you can see we've augmented in the spirit, in the visual spirit of Kumba. If you followed Kumba in the early days, you know it was always the more the merrier plan.
Here we are.
That's right. There's a lot of horns and drums, and we got a bass player in it too, but there's always a lot of horns and drums. And back in those days, the truth is that the rhythm section was way ahead of the horns. So let's tell you that. They'd be kicking our ass. We'd be dragging. But hopefully we're caught up finally.
Is that right, Dave?
But as you can see, we've augmented the band.
Oh, yeah. Dave.
Oh, well, Dave. Where is he? Okay, we can. With Dave Springer, also one of our original bass players, an East Sider. He surprised us the other night and brought in Sule Neal, which we hadn't seen. We've lost touch with Sule, so this is it's a big reunion for us also. But let me introduce quickly the guys. RJ, a good friend of RJ's. Ramsey Hussein. We got here today. If you follow the great guys, see you all. Obviously, no Jallo, John, Dave. Scratch up. He's going to play a couple numbers. If you know RJ's endeavors, you got Mr. Goody Weiss, the third. And like I said, once again, if you know anything about jazz, I'm sure you know about John Douglas. We've also got with us tonight Carl D. Horn on trombone. And rounding out is an old, old friend of ours. We go all the way back. He just finished his master's. Finally got a master's years ago. That's like a $50 gig. Right? Mr. Joe Mara. We got the knowledge Mr. Scott Strawman. He was involved with Fiddlers when we did our first recording. The last session. I guess we got Al Rudy goes way back with us too. The first final session the Sunbusters ever did was with at Al's studio. All right. All right. Enough of this.
Let's do it.
That's right. Here you go. Goomba. Oh yeah, we do have a couple more announcements. There's a couple of members that are not here tonight because they have gone on. And our original music director of this band was Arnold Clarington. We knew him as Jabbar. RJ mentioned in the program, and you can follow up on that. But Jabbar was a, like I said, older than us, and he brought in some songs. He had a little more experience than us, and he became the first music director of the band. And so it's only fitting that we're going to start with one of his songs. It's one of his songs in five called Three Finger Fist.
He also was the baritone sax player on a song called War, Edwin Starr.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.